you're here in church today, or maybe you're at home watching in front of your TV. It's really great to have you as part of today's service. Now, speaking of today, we have started a brand new series, and that series is called Disciple Makers. But, I mean, how do we make a disciple? I mean, what ingredients do we need? And what even is a disciple? Well, luckily, the lovely Winnie Heron will be here to tell us not only what a disciple is, but the importance of having trust. So we thought today's topic would be build trust. Now, speaking of today, we always have the big idea, and that's the thing we want you guys to take away whenever you're watching this current series. And the big idea is that I can share God's love. I can share God's love. And as you guys know, every week at Hope Discovery Kids, we also do an energizer. Now, this one's going to be an excellent energizer because the question is, do you think we're going to be able to walk on a carton of eggs without breaking them? What do you think? I don't think you can. Well, stay tuned and wait for that to see if we can. And also what we do at Hope Discovery Kids every week is we go across to our craft section, and the amazing Cooper family are going to be sharing a great craft about when Jesus got baptized. Yep, even like I've been baptized, even Jesus was baptized. So wait for all that very shortly. But before we do the craft, before we do the amazing word, and before we do the excellent energizer, I want you guys to stand up, get on your feet, because we're going to start worshiping God with these awesome songs. Let's go, team.
Surrounded, your love is everywhere and I'm surrounded. It's got me singing, it's got me shouting, and now I wanna tell the world about it. Cause now I am alive, yeah, you opened up my eyes. Everywhere I look I see.
Okay, well, we're getting to the energizer part of today. Now, as I said, it's going to be an excellent energizer. Is that right? It's going to be excellent? Yeah? Still pretty funny, isn't it? No, not really? Okay, well, what we're going to do is we're going to see, do you reckon we could walk on a carton of eggs without breaking them? Do you reckon you can?
No.
Don't think we can. Well, to do this, I have asked for a special volunteer to help me. Now, I'm going to ask for a Treyu to come up to here, and everyone encourage a Treyu as he comes up. Very, very brave. Thank you for coming up, young man. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to see if you can walk on these eggs without breaking them. Do you think you can? I don't know. I think he's going to break them all. What do you guys think? I mean, come on, eggs break pretty easy. Going to break them all? Yeah, I think he is too. Okay, well, let's see how you go. So you stand at the back there for me, Atreyu. Thank you. I'm just going to hold your hand so you don't, I don't want him falling over. Okay, when you're ready, let's see how you go. You ready? Everyone ready? How about we say 3, 2, 1? 3, 2, 1. Let's go. Oh, they're not breaking. Didn't break. Give you a hand. Woohoo! Look, I'm going to show. He didn't break one egg. But isn't that amazing? Do you know, because you know, one egg, I could easily break one little egg. And you know what? It's like when we do cooking and stuff. We can easily break this egg. And this egg, to me, is kind of like the promises sometimes we give to people. Sometimes I give to people. But sometimes, you know what? I make a promise, and I must admit, I don't always keep that promise. Sometimes I break my promise really easy. But when we look at the carton of promises, it's actually like God's promises. They don't break. Just like a tray you walked over there without breaking any egg, God is like the same. So when God said that he was going to send his son Jesus to help and protect us and to care for us, that's exactly what he did. He sent his son and he cared and protected us. So we know that because God loves us and he keeps his promises, we can trust him. You know, speaking of trust, I remember about 10 years ago, my wife Katie and I, we went on a really big world trip. And we went all around the world and we flew into a country called Spain. And that's in Europe. And we went there and we thought, this is going to be really exciting. And we flew in there and we went to talk to people. And guess what? Everyone pretty much spoke Spanish. I mean, look, come on, we knew they were going to speak Spanish because it's in Spain, but hardly anyone actually spoke English. So we didn't know where to go, what to do, or anything like that. And I remember we were in this really big courtyard, and we were just praying that God would give us some sort of help and direction. And as soon as he did that, two people came up to us, and they said, in English, they said, do you speak English? And we're like, yes, we speak English. And they said, do you need somewhere to stay for the night? And we're like, yes, we do. So they helped us find our place for accommodation. They took us out for dinner, and because one of the people there could speak Spanish, they could interpret and help us order what we wanted to. And they helped us the next couple of days in Spain, and we became really great friends with them. So that's just one of God's promises that I wanted to share that said, you know what, when we ask God to do something, he will actually do it, so I know that I can trust him. Now, just before we finish up, Atreyu, let's make sure these are actually really eggs. So, do you want to break this egg for me? Do you want me to break it? Do you want me to make sure it's actually a real egg? All right, we'll do it. Ready? Let's see. Ah, it actually is a real egg. So even though that egg broke, we know the promises of God don't break. All right. And I spilled it a little bit, but that's okay. All right, well, next up, we've got our Bible clip. Guys, watch this right now.
Come and see the baptism of Jesus. This is Jesus.
Heyo!
Who's the Son of God and the Savior of the world. Jesus was born in Bethlehem and grew up in Nazareth, where he grew in wisdom and favor with God and man.
Oh, I see.
This is John the Baptist.
Hey!
John loved God with his whole heart.
Hey, all you.
And he told everyone that the Savior of the world was coming soon.
Wow!
Come on.
John baptized people in the Jordan River.
Woo-hoo!
And one day, Jesus went to this river to be baptized by John.
Hold on.
But John tried to talk him out of it. Jesus said, "It should be done, for we must carry out all that God requires."
Okay.
So John baptized Jesus. And as Jesus came out of the water, the heavens opened and John saw the Holy Spirit coming down as a dove and resting on Jesus. A voice from heaven said, "This is my dearly loved son, who brings me great joy." And John knew, without any doubt, that this was the one they had all been waiting for. This was the chosen one of God, who would take away the sin of the world.
Hello, everybody. I'm Heather. This is Emmeline, Liliana, and Jamison. And we're going to show you about our craft today. We're going to do a craft, and it's called Jesus is Baptized. So it's a bit of a fun one. So for this, we need the printout that has Jesus and John, the Holy Spirit dove, and a cloud. We need a clear plastic cup, scissors, colored pencils or crayons, and we need some blue tissue paper. So we've got some blue crepe paper and some dark blue tissue paper. And so for this we need two icy pole sticks for each craft, some double-sided tape, and some thin cardboard. We've got bright yellow. So here we're colouring the pictures. So now, we're cutting out our little figures. So here we're ripping up our tissue paper and crepe paper to use as water. So we're sticking the dove to the bottom of one stick and Jesus to the top of the other stick. So we've made a slit in the bottom of the cup and this is where the paddle pop stick of Jesus will go through. So we fill up the cup about 3/4 full with the tissue and crepe paper for the water. And we stuck John to this inside of the cup with some double-sided tape. So that goes through the bottom of the cup. And that way we can show when John baptizes Jesus. So we've colored the front of the sun rays. Now we are reinforcing the back with some light cardboard and some double-sided tape. This is so we can stick the sun rays to the side of the cup so it looks like there's sun shining over when Jesus got baptized. So this craft reminds us of Jesus' baptism when God sent the Holy Spirit and said that Jesus was God's son. He was loved and God was pleased with him. We can trust Jesus because God confirmed that Jesus was his son.
Something's going on.
Welcome. I am so funny. All right. So we're starting a new series, and we are learning that Jesus wants us to be his disciples who will go and help other people become disciples too. That means we become disciples, and then we go and help other people become disciples. That means we go and make disciples. That means we're going to be disciple makers. But what is a disciple? What's a disciple? Can I hear some answers? Yes. A person who tells a story about God? Yeah. What else? A follower of someone? Yes. Did you put up your hand? No? Okay. Anyone here? Yes. The people of God. Wow. They are all really good answers, and you are all correct. A disciple are the people of God. They are the people who follow Jesus. A disciple is someone who follows a leader. And now this is a little bit different from following someone on the internet. Like when you watch someone on YouTube and you go, oh, this guy is so cool, I'm going to subscribe. But that's different from a disciple, because I subscribe to so many different people. What I do is I watch a little bit of their videos and go, ooh, so cool, but I don't follow them around all the time, do they? A disciple is someone who follows the leader everywhere they go, learn from them, watch them, everything they do, and then copy them. Okay? It's just like the old song says, following the leader, the leader, the leader, following the leader. wherever he may go, not whenever he posts a video, right? Wherever he may go. So Luke Skywalker is the disciple of Obi-Wan Kenobi. Can you think of anyone else who is a disciple of someone? Loki? Oh, we're going into Kylo Ren and all of that. I don't know any of that. I'm sorry. But I do know that the minions are the disciples of Gru. Well, kind of. All right. Now, Jesus had many disciples. Jesus actually had more than 12 disciples. He had many, many disciples, but he appointed, out of those many disciples, he picked 12 to become his apostles. They're like the team leaders of the disciples, if you'd like. Now, what did Jesus' disciples do? They followed Jesus everywhere he went, and they watched Jesus. They keep watching him, and then they're like, ooh, what would Jesus do there? What would Jesus do there? What would Jesus do there? And then everything Jesus told them to do, they did. Now, Jesus wants you to be a disciple too. He wants you to follow him and learn from him. But Jesus is not here, right? You can't follow him everywhere he goes. So how do I learn about Jesus? How do I learn about Jesus? From the Bible, yes. When I read the Bible, I go, oh, Jesus is like that. And I read the Bible, oh, Jesus is like this. And then when I pray to Jesus, I love Ben's story earlier. He said they got to Spain and they couldn't speak Spanish. And they prayed and God sent someone to help them. And it's the same. When we pray, we see God giving us what we ask and helping us. And we begin to know what Jesus is like. And then Jesus wants us to be his disciples. That means we follow him, we learn from him, and then we copy him. We be just like him. So, what does Jesus want us to do? Firstly, Jesus wants us to love our friends. Do you have friends? No? I'm sure you have friends. You have friends? How many friends do you have? 28. My goodness. One friend. That's good. Having one friend is good. 23. Very good. 109. Very good. Now, do you love your friends? Jesus wants us to love our friends. It's actually quite easy to love our friends. But you know what? Jesus tells us to do this. He wants us to love our enemies. These are the bullies, the baddies, the bad guys. Jesus says, I want you to forgive them. I want you to love them. Do you think that's easy to do? And then Jesus says, be kind. When your parents give you a bag of lollies, what do you want to do? Eat them all. But Jesus wants us to share them, okay? Sometimes it's not very easy, but Jesus wants us to be kind. Jesus wants us to help people. Jesus wants us to tell people about his love. That's what Micah said earlier, that a disciple tells people about God's love. But the question is this, how do we know that Jesus is the right leader to follow? If we follow a wrong leader and we copy them, we can end up being really bad, right? So what if, just have a think, what if Jesus was a bad leader teaching us wrong things? If we were following someone, we need to make sure that they are the right leader and that we can trust them. Otherwise, we could end up behaving and thinking in the wrong way. That's why it's very important what we watch on YouTube. Because sometimes we can watch someone who is actually teaching us the wrong things. And if we keep following them, we end up behaving and thinking in the wrong way. So how can we be sure that Jesus is the right leader to follow? So we watched the video earlier about Jesus' baptism. As Jesus was coming out of the water, the heavens opened and the Holy Spirit came down on Jesus like a dove, and a voice from heaven. Whose voice is that? God. God the Father. God's voice saying, have you ever heard the God talking to you through the sky? No, but it happened at Jesus' baptism. And God said, this is my dearly loved son who brings me great joy. Now, this is God who made you. God who made the whole world. God who is in charge of everything. And then he says, Jesus is my son. And he makes me so happy. Wow. Where can you find a better leader to follow? Jesus is the best leader we can follow because he was there when the world was created. He was there when God was creating you in your mommy's tummy. He was there and he knows why God made you. So that, and he loves you and he wants you to follow him. So we can trust him because he is the best one to follow. He knows everything and he loves us, okay? Now, when Jesus' disciples first started following Jesus, they actually didn't know Jesus very much. They knew that Jesus was very cool and they wanted to follow Jesus and they said, okay, we will follow Jesus. So they followed Jesus. But as they followed Jesus, they were watching him. Is he really the right guy to follow? And every day they just see that Jesus is, whoa, he is more awesome than I thought he was. Whoa, he is even more awesome today. And the more they saw, the more they trusted him and the more they followed him. And then the more they followed him, the more they saw, so they trusted him more, so they followed him more. So it's the same with us. When we start following Jesus, sometimes we don't know very much yet about Jesus. And we are like, okay, we're going to follow Jesus. So we read about him in the Bible, we pray, and then we watch God at work when we pray and do amazing stuff. I love worship. When we sing to God, we sing about how amazing he is. Sometimes he fills my heart with his love in a powerful way. And the more we follow, the more we see how awesome Jesus is, and the more we can trust him, and the more we can follow, and the more we can trust him, and the more we follow, the more we trust, and the more we trust, the more we follow. In the weeks to come, we're going to, now that we know what a disciple is, in the weeks to come, we're going to learn how to help other people become disciples. But now I have a question to ask you, everyone. I have a question, very important question, the most important question that anyone could ask you in your life. What flavor ice cream? No, that's the wrong question. The right question was, will you be a disciple of Jesus? Think about it. Do you really want to become a disciple of Jesus? Think. Will you trust him? Yeah? Yeah? And I think this is the best decision you can ever make. I'm going to invite Ben up here to stand with me, and then I'm going to pray for you. Okay? Now, if you want to be a disciple of Jesus, you follow this prayer in your heart. Is that okay? I pray. Actually, why don't you just copy me? I pray and you pray. Is that good? Okay, let's close our eyes and pray. Dear Jesus, I want to follow you. I want to trust you. Holy Spirit, will you fill me like you filled Jesus? Help me learn about Jesus. Help me follow Jesus. Help me copy Jesus. And help me see how awesome Jesus is. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you.
Wow, well, let's give it up for Winnie. What a great job she did. Thank you, Winnie. That was really, really amazing. I really love the fact that she made it so clear to each and every one of us what an actual disciple is and how we can choose to follow Jesus. And even though we don't always know Jesus fully, we know that with the promises he gives us and we learn to trust him, we know that we subscribe to the person we need to really subscribe to, and that's Jesus. So where to from here? Well, we have a thing called Next Steps. And what that is you remember our craft section we did with the amazing Cooper family? So do you know what? You can actually do that later on today. So on the Hope Discovery Kids Facebook page, there are clear instructions, really clear instructions on how you can actually make that crafting that we did with the Coopers, and we can see Jesus and how he was baptized. You can do that as well. So I want to really encourage you to do that when you finish today. Now, do we remember what the big idea was? It was, I can share God's love. I can share God's love. Now, make sure you're coming back next week. Next week, we have the amazing Melissa Richards, who's going to be talking about be willing. So I would love you guys to be willing to make sure you're coming back or tuning in if you're at home again next week, and be willing to come along this journey and learn about becoming a disciple maker. Now, remember those promises we talked about before? But you know what? There's actually heaps and heaps and heaps of promises that God put in the Bible for us to learn about. And it's going to be on the screen. You're going to see a list of promises that are on the screen that you can go through as part of your family time when you finish Hope Kids today. And along with that, there's also going to be some amazing discussion questions. There are things that mum and dad or big brother and big sister, you might like to ask the kids about little different things that just go a little bit deeper with today's talk that we had today. Well, I just want to say thank you, Winnie. Thank you, team. Thank you, everyone, for being part of today's service. You guys really did make a difference on this Sunday morning. I know it's nice and warm now because you guys have brought the energy. So thank you for doing that. Thank you for making me nice and warm. May you guys have a great afternoon, and we'll see you next time at Hope Discovery Kids. Bye.